Now, you may have noticed that I have not yet included Donald Trump in our coverage of the Republican presidential campaign this season, and that is because he is obviously never going to be president. He is obviously never going to be the Republican nominee for president, and he is obviously never going to be a candidate for president.
I just want the president to stop lying and making stuff up.
You're opposing fake news and alternative facts. How do you conceive of that working?
We just want to raise the issue. The best way to oppose fake news is for people to watch outlets like MSNBC, where you report real news all the time. And keep in mind, the president is scared that people will watch MSNBC, so you must be doing something right. Thanks for speaking truth to power.
In the beginning of the show, I want to get your reaction to it now, because okay. I don't want you to leave the building.
I'm not going to. You've now got
me.
I'm stuck.
And hear about this later, because no one knows more about this subject than you do, so I want to get your reaction to what it could mean if true, and I stress if true, because this is a single source who has told me that the Deutsche Bank obtained tax returns, which they do have, of Donald Trump's, show that the president pays very little income tax.
What I have here is a copy of Donald Trump's tax returns. These pages are straightforward. He paid $38 million in taxes.
Talk to the hand, because the face don't want to hear it anymore.
What's your guess on your percentage of income that's paid in taxes?
You know what? And I've said this many times, so it's not exactly breaking news. I pay as little as possible. I fight like hell to pay as little as possible.
Income tax. That's probably not going to be very surprising to people, probably not going to be especially politically damaging, since he ran saying, I try to pay as little as possible. Then there's the other part, the loan documents. And that is part of what this subpoena is going after. And this single source bank has told me.
You are fake news.
That the Donald Trump's loan documents there show that he has co-signers. That's how he was able to obtain those loans. And that the co-signers are Russian oligarchs.
What? Really? Trump himself. Of course, we haven't seen much of his tax returns, but from the president's own financial disclosures, it appears that he owes more than $300 million to a bank called Deutsche Bank. But
that would explain, it seems to me, every kind word Donald Trump has ever said about Russia and Vladimir Putin, if true. So now I have to chase those stupid goddamn entrails that you allowed him to stick out there. Jesus Christ. Crazy fucking sound coming in my ear, this fucking stupid hammering. I stress the if true
part of this. Yeah, that is a scenario that I have never contemplated, let alone, like, gamed out in detail. But So, I mean, that obviously would be absolutely flummoxing. But I don't know. I'm going to now sit and watch your show.
It would test the Trump theory that he could shoot someone on Fifth Avenue and his supporters would still be with him.
Yeah, man.
It
seriously.
The totally inaccurate reporting by Lawrence O'Donnell, for which he has been forced by NBC to apologize, is no different than the horrible, corrupt, and fraudulent fake news that I and many millions of great supporters have had to put up with for years. So bad for the USA.
Last night on this show, I discussed information that wasn't ready for reporting. I repeated statements a single source told me about the president's finances and loan documents with Deutsche Bank, saying, if true, as I discussed the information, was simply not good enough. I did not go through the rigorous verification and standards process here at MSNBC before repeating what I heard from my source.
Yeah. That man has a Harvard education. Did you catch that? The source, if true. Yeah. A single unverified source to make a wild accusation, a truly wild accusation. But basically, it's the same standard that the Trump dossier was based on.
Had it gone through that process, I would not have been permitted to report it. I should not have said it on air or posted it on Twitter. I was wrong to do so. This afternoon, attorneys for the president sent us a letter asserting the story is false. They also demanded a retraction. Tonight, we are retracting the story. We don't know whether the information is inaccurate, but the fact is we do know it wasn't ready for broadcast. And for that, I apologize.
And now, less than 24 hours later, after a threat from the president's lawyers, that man had to retract his claim. Today he tweeted this, quote, "Last night I made an error in judgment by reporting an item about the president's finances that didn't go through a rigorous verification and standards process." So just pause. He's talking about NBC News, a completely fraudulent news organization, a rigorous process. Excuse me.
This is insane because he keeps trying to me, there's a little nuance here, he keeps trying to justify the fact that he ever mentioned it in the first place by saying, well, we don't know if it's inaccurate.
We don't know whether the information is inaccurate.
Well, we don't know if it's inaccurate, and we don't know if we have all of the information. Well, clearly you don't, because you had one single source that didn't even see the documents in question, but it was good enough for their confirmation bias. So Lawrence O'Donnell and his editors, they decided to run with this story. It's reckless. This is the kind of stuff that, this is why that whole phrase fake news was created.
If true, those are the important words of the night. If true. That's the phrase that we always use when discussing stories that aren't yet proven to be true. And that's the language that I used here repeatedly last night at this hour when BuzzFeed reported that Michael Cohen has told Special Prosecutor Robert Mueller that President Trump ordered him to lie under oath to Congress. Is Michael Cohen, if this is proven true, guilty of lying to Congress as a crime? Is he guilty of perjury as a crime? Is the President of the United States guilty of suborning perjury if this report is true?
Yes, yes, and yes.
Donald Trump continues to get away with this kind of lying because the news media has not yet figured out how to deal with a pathological liar who will tell you what you did not see, even though you actually did see exactly that on video with your own eyes. But everyone in the Trump administration has done everything they possibly can to make that trip more dangerous, more deadly. They destroy water supplies that are left in the desert by Samaritans who are doing what Donald Trump's Bible tells them to do. But everyone in the Trump administration, they destroy water supplies that are left in the desert by Samaritans.
Yeah. When you look at those pictures, what they're not telling you is they're not telling you exactly why we would dispose of that water. If that water heats up in the desert, it's actually a lot more dangerous to drink extremely heated water than what it is if you don't have that water at all. So what our agents are doing is they're actually taking a humanitarian effort to try to save these individuals.
What happens with them? If they're doing a story about me, I know if it's honest or false.
This is the president lying about the media. He is telling his audience that the media lies about him. And he is lying to this audience about what he said, and he is lying to this audience about what the media said.
Right, and he's giving a wink and a nod to neo-Nazis and white nationalists, right? But here is the real frightening part, Lawrence, is that yes, he's lying, and he's lying to those people at that rally, and it's not going to make a bit of difference, right? The core of his supporters are not moving off of him.
The other big problem with going to a Trump speech live is the extent that he is willing to lie and lie directly to a television audience that we have a responsibility to monitor. That Donald Trump knows that he should not have said on many sides because he dare not quote himself tonight having said that.
And I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally.
Yeah, Lawrence, he also said that a lot of the people marching with the white supremacists and the neo-Nazis were very good people, and he's not bringing that quote up either.
Because they should be condemned totally.
But Donald Trump could only talk about his own suffering at the hands of the national media, and that suffering is them accurately reporting what Donald Trump says.
Now, elsewhere in those remarks, the president did condemn neo-Nazis and white supremacists. So he's not saying that the neo-Nazis and white supremacists are very fine people.
Because we covered it accurately and we reported what he actually said, which he is now tonight afraid of saying what he actually said the first time. Some of them were very fine people, the president said. They all shouted, "Jews will not replace us," all of them. And Donald Trump says that some of them are very fine people.
And I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally.
You live in a country where most people disapprove of Donald Trump, and most people have disapproved of Donald Trump every single day of his presidency, especially the days when he defends Nazis and racists.
Because they should be condemned totally.
You could argue that Bill Clinton gave his attackers some openings by having to admit to certain sex scandals and having so many rumors about right. other things like that. Barack Obama has given them no such opening in any way. And is that why they revert to things like imagining death panels and just pulling things out of thin air?
Yeah.
NBC has created a monster, and it is called Donald Trump.
I've created a monster. Cause nobody wants to see Marshall no more. They want Shady. I'm chopped liver. Well, if you want Shady, this is what I get.
Trump could have announced today that he's going to run for president, and NBC could continue to run his show without having to give equal time to other candidates for president. If Donald Trump has committed to do that, he is obviously not running for president. And all of this, every bit of it, is as fake as Donald's fake reality show, where he pretends to fire some very sad people. NBC has created a monster who is using his NBC fame to spew hatred, reeking with racist overtones and undertones about the president of the United States. NBC can no longer stand idly by, not for one more day.
It's really amazing. When I don't like somebody, their shows do really badly. Maybe it's subconscious, maybe it's will over matter, who knows? But their shows do really badly. Lawrence O'Donnell, his show is failing, it's a disaster. They moved him out of the 8 o'clock slot because Bill O'Reilly was absolutely killing him. They gave him the less coveted 10 o'clock spot, and he's dying at that. Lawrence O'Donnell show is a complete and total disaster. Move from a coveted spot. Now, even at 10 o'clock, it's a mess. So I have an idea. Maybe Rosie O'Donnell and Lawrence O'Donnell, and they must be related somewhere along the line, they should get together, form a show, and they'll have the lowest rated show of all time. What a good idea.
Another piece to add to that mosaic of racism that describes Donald Trump and his father ever since his father was arrested at a Ku Klux Klan meeting in New York City before Donald Trump was born.
Ever since his father
was arrested at a Ku Klux Klan meeting. Hold it now.
Has always been a stain of racism on the Trump name, a stain the president cannot wash off because he has never tried to.
Hold it now.
The Quinnipiac poll matched five of the Democratic candidates against President Trump. It showed all of those candidates with solid leads over President Trump, with Joe Biden again at the top of the pack. Joe Biden polled 54% against President Trump's 38%. Bernie Sanders is ahead of Trump, 53-39. Elizabeth Warren is ahead of Trump, 52-40. Kamala Harris is ahead of Trump, 51-40. Pete Buttigieg is ahead of Trump, 49-40. In the Quinnipiac poll.
Where Hillary Clinton is doing well, she has a lead in the polls. The latest one, a CNN poll, she's at 47. Trump's at 42. That is actually a tie within the 3.5% margin of error. Could be a tie. The numbers could also be 3.5%. Hillary could be above 50. Trump could be below 40. The margin of error goes both ways. But in the battleground state poll, on the question of who is better prepared to be president, which may be the most important internal question of all, Hillary Clinton way ahead in Florida, 60-31. In Ohio, 57-33. Pennsylvania, 59-32. David K. Johnson, that is the essential question that voters will be considering when they cast their vote for the presidency. And that is just an astronomical lead for Hillary Clinton on that issue of who is better prepared to be president.
Donald doesn't understand taxes, even though he says he knows more about taxes than anybody else. He does not understand trade. Even the Conservative Tax Foundation says that his tax plan, which is pretty sketchy, would lead to $12 trillion of larger federal debt over the next 10 years. $12 trillion.
He put glasses on so people will think he's smart. And it just doesn't work. You know, people can see through the glasses.